Here's a quick tutorial that will show you how to add button eyes to your doll and also how to glue on safety eyes. And I'm going to show you two different methods. One is how to glue the eyes in, the safety eyes in, and one is how to add buttons. Now this is just a regular button. This will work for a solid button that has a hole in the back as well. If you have solid buttons, those will work. This one's already been put in, and you can see there's no yarn tails to be seen on the back, and it's securely on there. It's not going anywhere. I'll show you that in a minute. Now all my other videos, I've always used fabric tack or tacky glue, and that works well. The only problem is it can get onto your doll if you don't do it exactly how I show you. Now I found this new stuff here, and it's called Fabric Fusion, and it's in a pen. I mean, how cool is that? And you can get it right on the stem of the safety eye, and you don't have to worry about it going all over the place. Now this stuff works really well. I just watched a video on YouTube, and the lady was using Fabric Fusion to add glass, metal, plastic beads to her fabric. And apparently this stuff holds it on, and you can even wash the thing after it's dried. Okay, so this one has been glued in already, and I'm going to show you how to do this one here. So what you want to do is you want to make sure that you're getting it on the stem. I get it all around the stem and all around the base of the stem. Now you don't want to put gobs and gobs and gobs because it will ooze out the sides, and you don't want to get this on your doll. Okay, and now we're just going to push it in there. And you can see some of that glue is going to be shoved right up to the behind the eye, and that's good. And I'm just going to push it in, and it's done. Now you're supposed to leave this for 2 to 4 hours. Let it dry for 2 to 4 hours before you start pulling on it. And if there's any glue on the outside of the eye, make sure you get that off. So I want to thread my yarn through the button, but my yarn needle won't fit through the buttonhole because it's just too small for the eye of the yarn needle. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take a regular sewing needle, and I've just made a little loop of thread. So I'm going to pull my yarn through that loop. And I've decided which side is going to be the front of my button. So I want to start through the back side. I'm going to crisscross through all these holes. So I'm going to come up through the back side, pull my yarn through, and then I'm going to go over one buttonhole and go back in. And I'm going to come through the back side again and back over on the remaining buttonhole. And there, I've just crisscrossed all those buttonholes. So I can take this thread loop off, and now I'm going to thread my yarn needle. So I'm just going to bend over the yarn and push the bend through. Okay, and I already know that I want the button to go right about there, so I'm going to go through a stitch hole and bring the yarn needle through the back through a stitch hole. Make sure you're coming through stitch holes. Go and thread the other one now. Now I'm going to go in, but I'm not going to go through the same hole that I have the other one going. I'm going to go one post over. And when I go out, I'm going to go through the same stitch hole that other yarn tail is coming through. So in through a different stitch hole and out through the same stitch hole. Okay, so now I could knot these off, but what I want to do is I want to add a little drop of glue back there. So I'm going to use my Fabric Fusion. Now I could pull those yarn tails tight. So now we want to knot these yarn tails off in the back. I'm going to do 2 knots. And I'm pulling a little tight because it makes a little bit of an indent here. It's kind of cute. And now I'm going to thread these, both these yarn tails again. And I want to get rid of this knot back here. So I'm going to go back in the same hole that these thread tails are coming out of. And I'm going to go down and come out somewhere else. Now I'm going to pull on these thread tails. I'm going to pull quite hard so I can bring up the thread tails as far as they'll come, and then I'll snip. And now when they spring back in, they're gone. And they're completely hidden away. There you go, button eyes. I think they're just as nice as the safety eyes. So I hope you found this tutorial helpful. Thanks so much for watching, and see you soon.